It's been a while. I'd forgotten I'd set the cat trap. But the question is it alive or dead? Right now, it's both. Actually, this doesn't really work. It's, you know, probably set in the program to be alive, so this isn't really a quantum thing. But in-game, it's a quantum thing, but, you know, so you don't have any poisons in there, so to really set the trap. If you don't know the Schrodinger's cat thing, then that made no sense. Okay, I have a specific thing I want to try to do here. And this is going to be a more pastoral video. It's going to be a little less hectic, hopefully. Let's see. Miscellaneous. Yeah, let's get another couple more garden plots here. Yeah, I'm not going to try to fall off the roof. There we go. Now we're going to plant. See, we're very low on certain things. Melons, we don't have a lot of. Razor green. That's a big razor green. I think the smaller one's better for our purposes. I only can do one of those. That leaves us some room, so that's good. Potato plant. We only have one. See, that's... We're low on potatoes. We're low on razor green. We have lots of moody fruits. Melons? Not so much. What else we have? Some gourds. Corn, we should have lots of corn, but I'll tell you. I've planted a lot of corn. And carrots, my goodness. You should all have the best vision ever. Okay, you're gonna leave a little development space for more corn and stuff like that. And of course you need people working on this, and we're kind of maxed out on peoples. So I have been working. Trying to get enough stuff together.
My systems are continuing to function at peak efficiency.
I hope you're finding the broadcast useful.
Oh yeah. Craft. You automatron. You should be able to build a few of these.
Casa del Radio Freedom.
Razor Ramon. Wrestling reference, anyone? Let us tab out. I'm not gonna do any mods to him yet. We're immediately gonna give him an assignment. Come on, Razor Ramon. You know what I'm doing with this, don't you? Yes, the razor grain. That's right. He's gonna be a farmer. And the nice thing is, I can build him and assign him. And then later, when I actually have, like, large amounts of aluminum. Confirmed. I heard it in the background. At some point, it should say, this resource was assigned. Come on. Resource assigned. Do I have to do it over and over again? Assigned. Assigned, assigned, assigned. He's slow, so it may take him a while. He has to get within range. Alright, we can come back to this. We'll check him in a minute. Oh, those Minuteman alerts. Yeah, it's right behind me. Alright, can we make another? These are so expensive. See, it depends on how many parts I have that it'll reuse. Rename this one. What goes good with potatoes?
Evening's drawing near. Perhaps we should seek shelter.
Look to the right, I can't see. Hold on a sec. That's the ticket. There you go. Take the station. Immediately go into workshop mode. Give him a command. He's still getting there. So that, hopefully they'll both be assigned someday. They're not very fast. Now let's see, we can do one more. At least. The great Tornado. I need. All right. Let's roll here. And right there. Okay. We assign him. That's interesting. The grain's not showing up yet. May I put them too close together for their purpose? Why is he walking back downward? Him is unassigned yet. And yet I assigned him. Come on. I told you. Horn.
Acknowledged.
Do we need to reassign any? Maybe assigning the potato is because it was on the same plot. Spuds is assigned to. Well, it's assigned to food. He's working on carrots, even though his name is Spud. Don't get me wrong, in the end result, it doesn't really matter.
Nothing to report. Keep it tuned here for updates.
But I do want the razor grain and the potatoes work. That's important. Razor Ramon, yo. You know what? Let's move it. So we have a razor plot and a potato plot. We've got. Let's find it. Great Hulk Polio is now unassigned. And he's unassigned. Okay, now he's assigned. Yo, idiot. Cornolio. That's what I name, get for naming a robot after Beavis.
This is Radio Freedom, broadcasting all across the Commonwealth. Nothing to report.
In theory, that they should auto-assign themselves to around six different plots. We should just continually get food. We do another one? Rename Melon Head. See, the nice thing is, I don't need them to be super killer robots. I mean, let's be honest here, we're pretty over. We're overpowered here as it is, in theory. I heard an acknowledged. I'm gonna let it go. Pop right out. I'm trying to build up more of these specific kind of rare foods. I mean, I've kind of over... I mean, it doesn't really matter, I don't think. If you got everybody just living off carrots, that's fine. New automatron.
I'm running out of cool names. Voice of the Minutemen. It's just past 10 p.m.
Nothing really got lovely carrot.
You got a real knack for destruction.
I'm gonna try an 8-0. We can always rename them when we come up with a purpose.
This unit is currently in factory default mode. Do you wish to enable this unit's personality subroutine?
No. Not right now. Yeah, let's just unleash them on the system. Hey, yeah,
sure.
We'll
that would be great.
Acknowledged. Personality subroutine activated. A pleasure to see you again, sir. Are you ready to depart?
Actually, I'll be back later.
Very well, sir. This unit is currently in factory default mode. Unit remaining in factory default mode.
Yeah, just stop. Okay, that's automatron 804.
By your command.
Good. There you go. We'll call him, let's see. Let's craft.
A pleasure to see you again.
Rename.
Sir. Are you ready to depart?
Out of my gourd.
Identity confirmed. This unit is ready to serve.
All systems go?
This unit is currently functioning at optimum parameters. Ready for next command.
Actually, I'll be back later.
Standing down.
Well, he's out of his gourd because I didn't put him in personality mode. That's one way to remember him. We'll get some more gourds out of this. Now, in theory, at some point, we can upgrade these guys to, you know, heavily armed turbo fighting robots.
This unit is ready to...
A pleasure to see you again, sir. Identity confirmed.
We'll let them walk on. Now, let's look at this. How are we doing food-wise now? I think it was like 48. Now we're up to 66. See, you know, it's kind of helping. People is up to 30. I must have done 5 robots. So the robots are counting. Let's just 30. Let's craft one more if we can. Just 2. Gourd, carrots, corn. Boy, I just didn't think. Tell you what, we'll give him a little more dignity. Let's see. After one of the local orchards. Right.
You're tuned to Radio Freedom. Nothing to report. Stay safe, people.
No. We want a fam rare. That's what happens when you type too fast, folks. Let's fix that. Fam rare. That's kind of funny in and of itself. Farmer, now into assignment mode. Come on, Famrare. Let's see, let's go find him a moody fruit plant. It's an interesting thing. I found this one on assigned, but mostly they're assigned. People must like the mud fruit plants there. The razor grain is still on assigned. That's a different razor grain. This razor grain is assigned. Okay. Hopefully, you know, the robots pick up the slack on some of these and we start getting some more of the more variety kind of thing. We're not just stuck with 10 billion carrots. Let's see. How much, I didn't even look. How much, Now we got 72 food for 31 people. And so every time you add a robot, it's considered a person. So the game considers robots people, let alone synths, right? Another deep philosophical issue. Stay safe out there. Oh, one of the things I did, might as well show you this while we're here, is I've moved my armor, my extra armor. I think this is the one I found north of Nantic or whatever it is. This is the one. I forget. I mixed these up where I got them from. This is my actual official boss armor that they gave me. I'm not sure I'm going to use it just because my lead armor is so much better. And I took the T60 armor off that, put that on one of these. Yeah, that's my original jetpack lead armor. And I put it on there, and I put the, even though it doesn't fit right and it tends to glitch out badly, graphically, I've got the X01 chest on this to give it a little bit more defensive capability. I don't know, really, what makes it better from this look at it, but, you know what I really should do? It's on display, and it looks cool.
My, my, how armored you look.
But, I'd have a lot more room in the apartment. I put this on display out here. Yeah, it'll get some rain. Transfer, Fushing Core, there you go. I put all my 100% and real high 90% cores in a drawer up in here too, so that... Now if I just activate this... Yeah, alright. So that's going to be my main set of armor that I'm going to actually use. And now it's not cluttering up the middle of the floor here. You can get to everything, and I think that's a better sort of thing. So yeah, here it's 1 o'clock in the morning. Not really planning to do much else here today. Just gonna decide to do that. Get some food going. Do we get any more food? Did it pick up? Not 72, that's about it. So at least we'll be contributing some things to the overall. And that's about it from your buddy the Black Knight here. Just sit down on the couch. Wind down a bit. Just waiting for the next complete bloodletting calamity. Thinking, what do I do with my life here now? Have a great night. Just a thought. Just a thought before we go. Where is this guy's head at this point? Having been through everything in the game, is he well adjusted? Or he just want to curl up in a ball. Don't know. I guess it depends on a lot of things. What his faith is, how driven he is, his personality type, and how well Deacon's sense of humor keeps him going, I guess, is at this point. But once again, this is the Black Knight. Have a great night.